Et bonjour à toutes et à tous, c'est Chou Sniper et aujourd'hui on se retrouve pour une nouvelle vidéo sur NBA 14. Merci de regarder cette vidéo jusqu'au bout et sur ce, bon visionnage.
Well, they played a very intelligent game of basketball, Steve, and those two things go hand in hand.
Collison, the pass to Granger. Lafitte to Jordan. Kicks it out to Granger. Rejected by Delfino. Jordan with it. Pass it to Delfino. Back to Jordan. Sanders with a screen on Granger. At five, it's Delfino outside, shot no good, so Los Angeles will take it the other way. This game against Milwaukee here, it's their first look at the Bucks.
Looking back at last season, this had to be one of their favorite opponents outside of their own conference.
Hits it to Jordan. About 1 minute into the first quarter, it's Jordan on the wing. Jordan off a pick from Sanders. To Mayo. There's the three. That's good. Mayo's got the first points up on the board for the Bucks. Steelers, I think, referring, I'm sure, to the 2-0 record you mentioned moments ago they had against them in the season series last year.
I think you're right, Kevin, and no matter what may have changed in the months since their last meeting, one thing that shouldn't change is the game plan. Plan of attack they used in those two wins. I know they've studied those tapes, but now it's a matter of trying to replicate those tapes.
Outside, Delfino.
Didn't matter that he was surrounded. He was the guy who muscled everybody else out of the way to get that board.
And it's the Clippers with the ball. 10-point lead. This is their biggest. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Griffin is doing amazing things on the court and off the court. I mean, his charisma and sense of humor really have made him one of the more marketable players in the entire league.
Going back to Griffin, he spent a summer interning with an LA-based comedy website, I'm reading that. I didn't know that.
Yeah, he has a love for comedy, and you know, playing in LA, that's a great opportunity for him to work in the entertainment side of things. And of course, he does have a real job with the Clippers. He's got focus there.
He does. You know, for those commercials he's in front.
They are good.
They're good. Here are the five the Clippers have to start the second. Blake Griffin down low and DeAndre Jordan. Then there's Danny Granger. Then there's J.J. Redick.
Well, with him, what immediately comes to mind is the long-range shooting. I mean, he can knock down shots from anywhere, and of course, that forces the defense to locate him at all times.
Something else I think of with him is that three-point shot from the corner. I mean, that's his shot. And we've certainly seen him drain a bunch of them.
Six to shoot. It's up a three. And no luck. And Milwaukee will come the other way. A minute and a half gone here in the second quarter. Mayo with it. Now guarded by Redick. Jordan hits to Delfino. And a miss there on the triple.
He has not been on his game, and you know their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not helped the situation.
Tries again, indeed, Granger drops it in. Granger's got 13 points.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, about just piling up points in the game.
Delfino passes to Jordan. Jordan off a pick from Pachulia. Jordan kicks to Delfino. Picked his pocket. Now the Clippers moving it up. And O.J. Mayo pulls it down. Bucks trail by 11. Delfino kicks to Jordan.
First four, he's come alive here in the second.
Bucks trail by 21. Udo kicks to Jordan.
inside to end the drought. Middleton can't get it to go.
And they needed that hoop to try to stop this run.
They just seem to keep coming up empty. They got to slow it down and get a good shot.
He gets it to go.
Well, as they continue to dominate, you wonder just how much higher this lead might get.
I think it really could get out of hand, and you can credit their defense just as much as their offense for that.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Here's Jordan. Knocks down the 10-footer. And here comes Collison. 9 points in the game so far. Barnes dishes to Collison. Barnes. Offline with his three. A dominating first half of basketball. And so far, hasn't been close. Back we begin our second half. So far, not a technically contested game, guys. But you know, anything can happen.
The Bucks have to reserve. It's Granger.
He's got 16 points, and he's hit the mark twice from three-point range as well.
Well, it's no secret. I mean, the more points he can come up with from out there, the better off they'll be offensively with their spacing.
Mayo and Delfino are the wings. Chris Middleton is out there with Sanders, and it's Jordan in point guard. That's the five to begin the second half for Larry Drew.
Kevin, I didn't like that defensive effort at all, but they're lucky he missed it.
Yeah, they were very lucky defensively because there was some miscommunication there. They left him wide open.
Collison with it, now guarded by Delfino. And Brennan kicks to Griffin. 6 on the shot clock. Jordan trying to free himself up. Griffin's shot is off.
Very porous defense down there by the hoop. He probably should make up.
Here's Delfino. Connects, the jumper drops. Delfino's got it going here in the start of the second half. The first points in the third quarter for the Bucks. Back to Griffin. And there's the call by the official. They'll count the basket here following the goaltending call.
He almost got to that shot in time, but not quite. You can't touch the ball once it's on the way down.
That whistle got a big response from this crowd, and it is not a favorable one, let's say.
I'll tell you what, the fans can't believe that they made that call.
Jordan hits to Delfino. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Jordan. Jordan's got 5 assists in the game. It's off his leg. And it's whistled a kick. Right around a minute and a half. Played here in the third quarter. Collison against Jordan. Collison the pass to Redden. Kicks it to Griffin. Backs him down. And it's good. Walk through contact. Hits the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
I'll tell you what I love about him. His ability to finish even while absorbing contact. He is so strong. Even with defenders hanging all over him, he continues to finish at the basket.
And also with him, don't think you can collapse the defense on him when he gets the ball to the low post, because he is a superb passer. He'll find whoever's been left open.
Find the shoot. Delfino with the three. It's hauled in by the Clippers. Jordan's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. That game is the first and last of their homestand.
Some good matchups out there. That Washington Wizards game, definitely worth checking out.
Delfino kicks to Middleton. He's got 5 points now this quarter. Bucks trail by 16. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Jordan kicks to Walters. Jordan with a screen on Barnes. Feeds to Knight. Milwaukee to rebound. Kicks to Jordan. On D. Misses. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Clippers. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for Los Angeles.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque. King of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
The other thing that's been huge for them is their points in the paint. They're getting the ball inside and converting on a regular basis.
Taking a look at Los Angeles. We got DeAndre Jordan. Danny Granger out there with Andre Kirilenko. Then there's J.J. Redick. And it's Collison at the one spot. It's taken away by Collison. Now, Redick. Back to Callison. The dish to Redick. All alone. Can't get it to go. And Milwaukee the other way now. Here's Delfino. Outside for Jordan. And there's the pass to Delfino. Back to Jordan. He dishes it to Delfino. And they force the shot clock violation. 13. Chance now to check out the schedule for Milwaukee. Next matchup, they'll be home against the Suns. That'll be the last of three straight at home for the team.
Boy, a lot of fans really focused on that matchup for Memphis.
They double in with Jordan. Pass to Jordan. Out of bounds. Milwaukee takes possession. Here's a quick look at how the Clippers' schedule is shaping up. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again. We're just over a minute into this final quarter of play. Delfino kicks to Jordan. Dishes it to Delfino. Back to Jordan. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession.
Such a careless pass. You've got to keep your head in the game here.
Los Angeles leading by 16. Collison, the pass to Kirilenko. And there's the whistle. That game's on clock. That's foul number two for him. Here's Kirilenko. Final quarter of play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it. Back to Jordan. Clock at six. Granger. Some nice ball movement by the Clippers. Deep two from Collison. Off the left rim and out.
Most of the time, next shot will go down. Well, the defenders have to make sure they tag.
And Walters kicks to Jordan. He passes to Delfino. Back to Jordan. Jordan off a pick from Zane. He feeds it to Delfino. Wide open. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Jordan. Jordan's got his ninth assist in the game now. Milwaukee's got eight shots off from three-point land and hit half of them. Back to Jordan. Sanders with a screen on Dallas. Jordan kicks to Mayo. Feeds it to Jordan. Milwaukee, no good that time either. Clippers leading by 22. Into Jordan. Rebound, Milwaukee. Sanders has got rebound number 13 for him here tonight. Jordan, the pass to Delfino. Back to Jordan. Jordan off a pick from Sanders. Jordan kicks to Delfino. Milwaukee the rebound. Into Ilyasova. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession.
Man, I don't know what happened right there. He just basically walked out of bounds.
He's gotten off four three-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen off his leg, and the refs whistling a kickball. Here's Collison. Second chance effort, and Griffin with the layup. Griffin's got 4 points this quarter.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint. Now, you got to make a defensive adjustment to your part. Time to collapse inside, force the ball back out in the perimeter, make them beat you from long range.
Jordan kicks to Mayo. From deep. Outside for Jordan. Lets it go from deep. That's good. Jordan's got 10 points here in the second half.
Well, he's having a great half here. Exactly the opposite of the first.
Back to Jordan. Offside Jordan. Granger outside. They double him with Jordan. Sanders with the steal. Delfino gets a screen from Ilyasova. Delfino dishes to Jordan. He feeds it to Delfino. On the wing. Offensive rebound. Mayo. Also, he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Some good play from Mayo in this one. He has 18 points. Those 4 3-pointers he did have helped him too.
Well, they'd be in a much different position in this game if he wasn't burying those long balls.
That's good for Mayo.
Well, the Bucks playing here at the BMO Harris-Bradley Center, one of the older arenas in the NBA in around a quarter century. And the Bucks have said they'll leave Milwaukee after the 2017 season unless a new arena is built.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles, Glenn Davis is checked in for DeAndre Jordan. Plumlee comes in for Blake Griffin. And Matt Barnes is subbed in for Danny Granger. And back to the arena situation here in Milwaukee. This is one of the smaller markets in the NBA. Steve, that can make it tougher to get an arena done.
Well, there's a potential change in ownership that has loomed over the franchise as well. Obviously, we all want to see the team stay in Milwaukee. A lot of great history here going way back. So hopefully an arena deal will get done.
The Bucks making a change here. Antetokounmpo is checked in. Jordan kicks to Antetokounmpo. Down to 5 on the shot clock. 11 feet away. Great tee that time from Green. Los Angeles has gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have fallen. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Pass to Bullock. Fires for 3. Rebounded by the Bucks. White with it. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession. So the Clippers win this one easily. Sunday's park, everything goes right for a team. I think this is one of those games.
Yeah, it certainly was. I mean, these guys played a great all-around basketball game.
Merci d'avoir regardé cette vidéo. N'oubliez pas de commenter, de mettre un petit pouce vert et de vous abonner à ma chaîne. Et moi, je vous dis à bientôt pour une prochaine vidéo. Allez, salut!